Thank you so much for that.
The Minister of Education and Sports, Janet Kataha Museveni, has expressed concern over the growing negative influence by role models who have only aided moral degeneration amongst the youth. She says that it's more essential than ever before for schools to place ultimate responsibility on subject instruction to block immorality that lies in wait for future generations.
Educators have the power to instill values and morals in learners, such as discipline, hard work, and respect for others. This is significant because, as we all know, education can and should be a cornerstone of every prosperous and forward-thinking society. Therefore, the growth and economic advancement of a nation is hampered in the absence of God-fearing, selfless, committed, and passionate educators.
The Vision Group Chief Executive Officer, Don Wanyama, has also noted with concern that moral degeneration has taken a pivotal toll upon the youth as they largely consume information from social media. He says that the Teen Vision magazine will address some of these issues facing the majority population in Uganda.
However, there's growing concern about the unregulated information that the youth pick from the social media. Moral degeneration of teens has been partly attributed to this. At various occasions, social psychologists have called for innovations to be able to address this challenge. With this product, the Vision Group is responding to this call by creating a platform for the youth to engage constructively. This product, Mama, we intend to use it to help the youth appreciate their identity and purpose in life, so that they can be able to live to their full potential.
Against this background, the minister commended Vision Group for this innovation, the Teen Vision, which in her belief will, among other issues, address the rising unethical behavior, solve issues of teenage identity, sexuality, and maintain Uganda's cultural values and norms.
Create a safe environment for young people to interact with each other with appropriate content and guidance from adults and experts. I'm informed that the Teen's Vision will cover some of the important issues that impact the youth, such as teenage identity, sexuality, building meaningful relationships, and youth and entrepreneurship, among others.
This was during the Teachers Making a Difference awarding ceremony hosted at the Vision Group headquarters in Kampala. During the ceremony, notable teachers who have made remarkable differences in the schools they serve were recognized. The Education Minister commended Vision Group for the Teachers Making a Difference project. She noted that the project breeds responsibility among its teachers and is a source of inspiration to the rest of the teachers across the country.
Now, with regard to developments in the education sector, you may be aware that the government, with the help of our partners in development, such as Ireland, has made significant investments in infrastructure development and interventions to improve the quality of education.
The minister appreciated the Irish government for the support given to the Ugandan education sector and urged the best teachers to serve as ambassadors on their week-long travel trip to Ireland.
I congratulate the 12 winners of this year's Teachers Making a Difference competition. Having been selected from among the 425 teachers nominated for the competition, I'd like to try and raise a fund that would enable the other six so that all the 12 can go to Ireland.
Vision Group CEO Don Wanyama highlighted the success of the Teachers Making a Difference project.
We celebrate teachers because teachers are role models and they are critical mentors to our young people, our children. They play a very crucial role in shaping the students' character, development, values, and ethical behavior. Teachers do not only impart academic knowledge, but also teach important life skills, such as resilience, empathy, and perseverance.
In today's awarding ceremony, 12 best teachers walked away with certificates, dummy checks of over 4.5 million shillings, with part of this money allocated to purchase of necessary equipment in schools, plus a travel ticket to a week-long study trip in Ireland. Report compiled by Derek Asaba for the news.